we want to simplify the given trig expressions. Normally this means we want to write the trig expression in terms of one trig function. If there's no obvious substitutions, we convert everything to sines and cosines and then see what simplifies. So for cosecant theta times tangent theta, cosecant theta is equal to 1 divided by sine theta, and tangent theta is equal to sine theta divided by cosine theta. Now that everything is in terms of sine and cosine, we can see we have a factor of sine theta over sine theta, which simplifies to 1. So this simplifies to 1 over cosine theta, but 1 over cosine theta is equal to secant theta. So now it's simplified to a single trig function, and it's normally considered more simplified if it's not in fraction form. Now let's take a look at our second example. Here we have secant theta divided by tangent theta. Well, secant theta is equal to 1 divided by cosine theta, and tangent theta is equal to sine theta divided by cosine theta. Now we need to remember that a fraction bar just means division. So we can write this as 1 over cosine theta divided by sine theta over cosine theta. But now we can also write every division problem as a multiplication problem. So instead of dividing by sine theta over cosine theta, we can multiply by the reciprocal, or cosine theta over sine theta. So we can write this as 1 over cosine theta times cosine theta over sine theta. And now before we multiply, we should recognize that we have a common factor of cosine. Cosine over cosine simplifies to 1. So this leaves us with 1 over sine theta. And 1 divided by sine theta is equal to cosecant theta. Okay, we'll look at several more examples of simplifying trig expressions in the next few videos.